Today I'm going to work on fundraiser orders, and then we're going to get an accurate calculation of the internal volume of my subwoofer box so we could finalize the tune and move on to making the front, because Russell fucked up my box calculations. Distracted me. I'm trying to calculate the internal volume with my calculator, and notifications are popping up because Russell leaving comments on my YouTube. It's his fault my math was wrong.
Who said I'm bringing heat on you? I gotta listen to people because of your fucking shit?
Now Russell's gonna have a field day because I need to move the mule, and it's been sitting for so long, probably doesn't even start up and run anymore. Russell's a fat whore.
Where the fuck you get?
Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds.
I'm using my cam software to find a perfect area of each layer so we could get an accurate volume calculation. According to my calculations, we're fucked. It's not gonna work. We have a total internal airspace of 1.37 cubic feet. It's not enough. I should have shaped each layer like a dick and shoved the box up my ass. Because I fucked myself. Can I help?
What? What the fuck?
For a 13W7, the box would need to be at least 2 cubic feet. Work and the port's too small. The JL woofer looks like an open butthole anyway. Back here. Look at it.
Oh, go figure. Look at that. Oh, look at that.
I'm gonna open my trunk. It's gonna look like a hooker version of C-3PO popping his ass out. Butt open, ready to be railed.
My name is Ipsy Sweat, and I'm also DJ. I didn't like this cool, so took another way. You like the money.
The priority for this trunk is to display the pumps and woofer with the lit internals of the box. So I think our most resistance is coming from this piece of shit JL woofer. I have half stripped. I razor bladed the fucking spider and dipped it in acid. And now I think I'm not going to use it. Which means I have a slightly used 13-inch JL Audio W7 for sale. Got a scratch on the basket. It's barely used. I barely put any power on it. It should be fine.
Doug.
Just fall down.
You're trying to trick me again? Now I'll move on to making the front of the box. These will be our birch trim rings that will be part of the box. And this will be our acrylic panel that holds the woofer that will sit into this one and be held in by this one. So there'll be mounting holes in this piece of acrylic for the woofer and the panel itself, because this needs to go on last. I had to stop this program early because this bezel is so thin the piece is about to fly off the table. Snap, piece of wood's gonna fly across the room, bounce off the wall, and impale me in the side. If I pull it off now, I can not only save my life, I could probably save the piece. Clean it up with a flush trim bit. Piece of cake. Now I can run the second layer of my front panel, and while that's running, I can sign some wooden penises. I make money for car parts by selling penises. I fucked so many mailboxes from around the world that my stamps.com account probably has a virus.
Doug, right now is not time for this. Right now is not the time.
This piece turned out perfect. Now I'm going to attach both pieces together, and once the glue dries, I can fix my bad edge.
You built that? Wow. That's very cool. I like that. Ta-da! Are you proud of your masterpiece?
I need more!
I like how it goes to a curve.
I need more and more!
More and more?
Yeah!
You used all my cups?
We'll be right back. The glue is dried. Now I'm going to use my flush trim bit to trim off the nastiness of this edge. The dangerous part here is that a small splinter of wood could fly off the table and impale my taint. 'Twouldn't be good. The edge is so thin it could snap. This is where Mark from the Fab Kitchen would pull out his push blocks from his turkey baster drawer. And then it happened. The router jumped, the trim panel snapped back, broke, slipped off, jammed my arm into the router bit, grinded my arm into hamburger meat up to my elbow. So I jacked off with it and called it the hand burglar.
Doug, right now it's not time for this.
Have you ever burgled your own hand? Mark hasn't, because he uses puss blocks.
It's not XXX material, you dirty dog. Seriously.
Yeah. It's not the time for this.
Then it happened. I created a front panel so amazing. Looks like a goddamn alien designed it. Laser cut so accurate. It's confusing to the human mind. Can't even comprehend this. I did it.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
A box so magnificent, but it's gonna sound like shit because my math. If I were to hypothetically pull my spare 13-inch focal off my shelf and test fit it in the box, just so happens to look perfect. Looks better than the piece of shit jail anyway. This woofer will work with less airspace and it'll be a better overall fit for the trunk with what we have going on. But I'll need to grab a fresh one once it comes time to finish up the box because this one's all scratched up.
This is the new Amplified shirt. This is the final sample that was approved. This is actually a new shirt and a new printing process. This looks dope.
There's a lot more ink on this one.
Look at this goddamn shirt. So magnificent, looks like the same alien robot designed it that designed this. You could buy yours now.
Another thing I noticed is, what's quite amazing is the abdominals under here. I mean, look at the abdominals.
Oh, go figure, look at that.
Look at the can I help you?
Next time I'll run this 13-inch Focal through our software and see how it's going to sound, but most likely this will want a sealed box. I believe this woofer wants about 1.5 cubic feet in a sealed box. Right now, as our box sits, we have about 1.4 cubic feet, so if we eliminate the ported layers and go all sealed, we'll gain airspace, giving us a lower tune on a sealed box with a 13-inch Focal, like it was made for it. Like I planned it the whole time to be this way. I was just kidding about the JL woofer. Piece of shit anyway. Boy, JL really fucked me this time. That was a working W7 that they fucked up. Blue. I barely even turned it up. Now look what happened. The paint fell off. I wonder if I could send it in for warranty. Barely even touched it. I'll keep picking away at this while I'm waiting for my hoses, fittings, and switches, which are ordered and they're on their way. They should be here any second. Then I can move on to putting some insert nuts in the floor, mount the pump rack, then we'll have to build a battery rack. Then I can register it and drive it and hit switches on your mama for the low price of $1,000 for registration and insurance. I spent all my money, I need to have another fundraiser. Thank you guys so much for supporting the show. Explosion t-shirts are now shipping. Grab one while you can, they are limited. Leave a comment, let me know what you think about today's episode. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by purchasing iPad dash kits and Soundman merch from soundmanca.com. Take your fabrication skills to the next level with the tools and trainings available from mobilesolutions-usa.com. Check upcoming training dates at mobilesolutions-usa.com/training. Go to ctsounds.com to get a discount on quality car stereo equipment with coupon code SOUNDMAN. See what kind of stereo system you could put together for your budget at ctsounds.com. Sada.